we go coro, they hear me whine whine. Now you say you turn that giddy bar on top of the chairman television station was Obia Maxibi, and this na cocoa of the matter. Every Wednesday from 7 o'clock for evening, we they carry the cocoa when they inside the matter. Those who understand Yoruba go know say when they say something na cocoa, na the most important thing when they inside the discussion. We go live up, live down, enter inside the cocoa. Carry person when sabi where to discuss the thing. The idea now so that all of us where they watch, we go learn. Most importantly, all the thing where we learn, we go put them into action to make this our country better. The person when I carry come, na elder statesman. When they say person na elder statesman, it means that a person will be say, when we talk about issue of Nigeria, the thing they special for in heart. And a person where they don't see plenty things for this country. So the stage where they don't reach, enough is spoil. Now, just so that the thing go better, now in the day about, and they talk of no other than my oga. Somebody will be say, are they learn work from? Somebody will be say, if in the drop talk, now wisdom, now in they come out from all the thing when they talk, Oga Shembore. You see, he got some names where we say, they're not just the gift person. You go, no, say this other person will say, when they born and they raise them up, say, no, you will make impact. You will touch lives. You are going to be there and nothing will spoil when you are there. Good evening and welcome to Cocoa of the Matter.
Allow me to start with my Yoruba language.
Confirm.
Sorry, the way you are praising me is as if I should just go to Central Bank and collect money.
Ah, if you need where you go, I will follow you for back.
Okay.
Just but, in case they give you, I collect. Just in case they hold you, I escape.
But having said that, it is of great pleasure to be with you.
Thank you very much. God bless you. Say you can waka come, and then we'll go discuss this very important matter. What is the very important matter? Anybody when they follow news inside the border of Nigeria, go know, say, what's in the rain now? Now, one group of people, when we say, they don't turn themselves to master of this country. Yes, now the truth. Because anything when they like, now then they do. And as they do anyhow, it can't be like saying they know they see anyhow. Because we don't hear say, not be all of them be bad people. Some of them are victims of circumstance. Make we handle them small, small. Some of them no be this thing, say they be super armed robbers. It could be like say people they take some kind terms to qualify them. Nobody won't call them bad people as them they. For English, oh, based on the way anything they inside news, then they call them bandits. And these people, they're responsible for so many badness what happen for this country. One of which, now the kidnap of schoolboys and some of the workers for inside Kagara for Niger State. Make we don't talk too much. Make we go straight into this thing. Say this thing, now read something. When some people get bad mind against because of what happened to them, or on an office, now they don't open. Once again, welcome to Cocoa of the Matter.
Yeah, thank you, my blessed Oga.
Thank you very much. We could just go straight into the discussion. As somebody when we say, you know, you the cities inside newspaper, virtually every day, you go read news. Some of the things where they see inside paper about this particular bad set of people, when they don't, they call bandits. Say bandito, disagreement between bandits, now they cause the delay of the release of these boys. We don't locate the bandits. We don't they follow the bandits, they talk. We know where the bandits then they. Some of these bandits, them now bad thing, now make them go to do this bad thing. As you they see them, how would it be your reaction? Shall you they react, especially when they look, say, ah, wait to. What do they do about this thing? Shouldn't I say we serious about this problem? I mean, this thing just be like a joke. I mean, maybe because they call the team bandits. It just now small hand that would use the follow-up. How you think they react to all this things when they say news?
Sorry, there is a saying that what is not good is not good. You don't have to be economical with the truth. When I was growing up, because I was fortunate to listen to Sheikh, which by the Islamic and my Muslim brother. Sheikh is a learned person. Now, person will be saying, when he talk, community go listen. When I was growing up, now in there, don't they do cattle rustling?
Cattle rustling?
Benny.
That all these people will go
come the jabba, come yeah. Jabba. They have been doing this right from in the 60s. But because then, there is no internet, there is no phone, there is no social media, nobody hear anything. Cattle rustling did not start last year. Did not start 2 years ago. But let me come back to your talk. According to the Oloyinbos, bandits na outlaw, na robber, which is equal to the people carrying gun to go and rob people in the house. It says that bandits are outlaws that are operating in a lawless society.
Voila.
That is the definition. Anybody can go and check. So are we now saying that Nigeria is lawless, number one? If we are giving so much razzmatazz to the word bandit, are we saying there is no government in this country? Are we saying that the country is, I repeat, lawless? If bandit is now something that you now negotiate with, that you now sit down and you start drinking cold juice, so where are we going? Bandit did not start today. In fact, it is until last year that the word bandit has become so glorified in Nigeria. Bandit is just a way of romancing and playing with armed robber. Kojubelo.
Romancing and playing with armed robber. And make I come to this particular one. Because if you like say some people, as you don't give us the definition of banditry and bandits, it is very, very clear. None of us be the first son of Queen Elizabeth. So we don't go talk about owner. Wait till we know we go talk. And you don't talk about people when they operate outlaws, when they operate for lawless arrangement. Everybody agrees say Nigeria, they governed by laws. Unless the people when we say, now then they arrange our laws, say we don't get law again. Now, if we don't govern by laws, now this business, what these people they do now, if we say it is illegal, and a problem, now then they cause. And person when they do something when they're illegal and they cause problem, the person is supposed to face the wrath of the law. Meaning say the law is supposed to show the person pepper because we not be lawless people. We are governed by laws. But we can ask, this thing now don't they be like say as we they see the thing as serious problem. Some people know they see a serious problem. As person when we say get children, if I look, say, wait, oh, somebody go school, go pack school children, carry them enter inside forest. After some days, the person release the children. We don't know how they take settle that particular one. Now again, they don't go Niger, go pack school children and workers, carry them go. We see they follow them, they discuss this discussion. See, for some people when they some part of Nigeria, bandits and banditry na serious thing. And for some other people, na different definition. What is exactly be the problem? Why if you say everybody know they see this thing as something when they serious?
You see, the problem with us in this country is that we oversabi book. Because if we not sabi book too much, what is bandit, what is banditry?
Okay.
We are now making it singular and plural. We are now making it present and the continuous tense. Kojo is, let us start with, you said that we are governed by the law. So is anybody above the law, number one?
Nobody there above the law.
If people, you remember this issue that we are discussing, in between a month, Kojo, to a month, it was Kankara first.
Where the president come from, Katsina.
In Katsina, just after Kankara, they go to Kagara in Kaduna.
KK.
So if Yobani, if leave the dance up top of water, on top of river, the drummer is under the
He's
river.
Under. Now they beat band under now.
Because how can you explain that some people enter into school, carry hundreds of students or children, one day, we don't know what exchange, whatever. What shall
we
need
just say glory to God.
Yeah, hallelujah. What you do? And then, it's not even up to a month. They went and carry. Don't you think there is something fishy somewhere? If people, let us go by the military tactics. There's something they call the rules of engagement.
Okay.
Before you have the rules of engagement, you must have done what they call your reconnaissance survey.
You go down check the place.
But you have gone round, you have used your aeroplane, you have used your helicopter, you have used your binocular, whatever you are using. And then there's something we now call again, surveillance. As you have done your reconnaissance survey, you are now monitoring them one by one. You blended into them, you are seeing everything. How come this thing is becoming a ball of fire? And our law people, I mean, our security people, I don't see them anywhere. How can you, let us ask ourselves a very one plus one. How can people carry over 200 students? Let me just cut it short. Now, boss, they just have been a helicopter.
Very important question.
And nobody see them. Do you know how long it takes to pack 300 children? Let us assume that they use bus. Do you know how many hours it will take you to arrange them inside the bus?
Boys, when we say power day or ginger.
How many hours it will take? And nobody saw anything. There was no alarm. And the school was there. No teacher, no principal or been a headmaster. Ah, Ejaba has told us something is wrong.
Something is wrong. Make we can focus on what it exactly be the thing when they wrong. Because if they talk say something is wrong, what exactly then is wrong? Make we go to one very, very talk when we say it don't generate plenty reaction from Nigerians. When I go remember, say when our Ogbonge visitor been the talk from the beginning, he been talk about one sheikh. He say sheikh, na senior scholar, Islamic scholar. And if na person will be say if they talk, people go to hear word. People when they follow this thing about bandits and banditry, go down the hear of one particular name, Sheikh Gumi. Sheikh Gumi, a senior person inside the Kodo Nigeria when it comes to religion arrangement. And if a person will be say, in the always talk about things, about government and governance inside the Kodo Nigeria, not be today start to put him out. Of recent, about these bandits them, in don't they talk plenty, plenty things. It just be like say, he know plenty things about them and what the problem be. In fact, recently picture surface of when he go inside where they stay for forest, go visit them. He been sit down with a new story person to discuss what he think, say somehow if they reason this thing, if it be the problem and what in the cause make these people they do what it they do. So I could just like make everybody now carry cutting board now first, clean your ear so that you go hear the thing well. We go play them so that everybody go hear. First clean your ear with cutting board. Now, when you hear that thing finish, we go follow the enter inside break. When we go the break, come back so that we go drink water because what didn't talk, I want to digest them well. Then we'll come back, come begin the break what didn't talk one after the other. Make we just pay attention. This now Sheikh Gumi. When they follow new story person, Sheikh Okimbaloye, they discuss. Make we hear.
And you see, even we call them killer headsmen. How many people did they kill? They only kill, sometimes some of them are on drugs. Some of them are on drugs. So that killing is not killing to, they want the money. So they're ready and they're comfortable. They can keep somebody as long as they are because they are in the bush, really, really in the bush. Getting there is very remote. They can keep somebody so they don't have, when they kill, it must be accidental. Maybe somebody they took who is sick. But tell me who has they have killed. How many few?
They've killed people.
No, they don't kill. If they kill, in the bus, they will kill people there. They want money from the people. They want, what do you call it?
They burned down houses. They've killed people.
This is another thing. That is the ethnic war. That's not mandatory. Maybe if a nomadic man went to that village and he was killed or lynched, so they come in a group and ransack the village, not to steal, just to revenge. And this is their mode of defense, instilling fear. It's just like the honey, when you want to take its honey, the whole bunch of soldiers follow you. This is exactly, so that killing is not the stealing, you don't combine it with the it's not because of, what do you call it, criminality, it's because of ethnic revenge. And they don't attack a village, except that village did something to one of them. In fact, you see that they will pass many villages and go to the one that they have problem and attack it.
Welcome back to Coco of the Matter. My Ogbonge visitor sitting with me inside studio. I will discuss banditry. For inside the northwest of Nigeria, we can they ask whether this thing is the latest business for this country. Una hear waiting Oga Sheikh Gumi get to talk. I say una hear and well oh, so that una body go calm down when una hear waiting in talk. My Ogbonge visitor, we don't hear waiting Oga Sheikh Gumi talk. Mm. And the way we need to talk him, he talk him like say the people when we they talk say them be the problem. Mm. They're different from these bandits because he say. They know they kill people. Mm. Say if to say them fit kill people, where then they even they carry people from? Mm. Or if they won't keep people, they will don't keep people there. Mm. But now money, now in them they find. I won't ask, no be who work, now in they collect money. Abi banditry don't turn new type of work. Mm. They get board of directors, they get office, then they clock in and clock out, then they do employee and employer review. Mm. I mean, what do you make of that talk when we say the Sheikh talk?
You see, We cannot be economical with the truth. Mm. When I, you know, earlier on, I talked about military rules of engagement. Mm-hmm. Let us start with the money that is paid to these people. Mm. Let us start from there.
Good.
This money that is paid, who collected the money, mm. number one? Mm-hmm. Where then they spend the money? Mm-hmm. Is it possible for you to pay out millions of naira? And that millions of naira you pay does not have serial number. Mm. It does not have any security thing on it that can they can easily pick up.
I mean, maybe not Bitcoin they use pay them.
Kojo, eh. Kojo, eh. Cash in your If they are paying them that huge amount of money, where they spend them and nobody can trace it? Hmm. Because we cannot just be saying they pay, it's a business. The money involved, where did they go? Where did they from come? Talo release the one. Having said that, Shegumi. Of is a respected person mm. because for you to call somebody Sheikh, mm. he don't read Quran mm. back and front, mm. he don't the interpreter,
he
don't sabi and pass. Mm. My God, let me ask you a very, very simple question. Mm. Sheikh Nagumi, they represent the government.
Ah,
that's the question. No?
Serious question.
Is he a representative of the three arms of government? Mm.
Serious question. No?
That is number one. Mm. How did Shegumi know where these people then they and the law people and the security people don't know?
And maybe these bandits them, this one are good bandits. the one when our security people then they follow, now bad bandits. Because he talk, I'm saying find them, go inside forest. If by the definition of what you give us, say bandits be outlaws
in a lawless environment.
So how come he know their own address, but our security will not sabi them? So maybe now he go tell us whether this one them be the good bandit and whether bad bandit today.
Let me turn the question around and ask you.
Okay.
Arm robber go to an area and then rent three streets. Mm. Somebody now say, I think I know where the arm robber they will. Mm. Let me go and negotiate with them. Mm. Do you negotiate with arm robber?
You're not going to negotiate now.
If you cannot negotiate with armed robber, why are we negotiating with bandits?
Maybe because of the bandit, their position of power. They hold the children. If you do anyhow, then go do anyhow to the children. Too. I just think like that.
Let us think deep.
Okay. Go deeper. Go deeper.
If Gumi knows where they are, our law and our security people don't know where they are. Mm. He's not the one now that is now what you call the devil's advocate. Mm. Allow me to use that word.
Nine day the middle.
Oh, Lord, he's not the one that is negotiating for the bandits. Mm. He's the one claiming that they are good. Mm. I heard him saying something like they are victims of circumstances. Because he said it is, if this thing, I don't watch him before. Mm. He said, the people that are doing this thing, they are nomads, Fulani. Mm. That is an ethnic war. Mm. Are they the only people that have lost their means of livelihood? Mm. Why is everybody not going into bandits? Let them now give an excuse that we have lost our means of livelihood. Mm. See, the truth is, monkey body, they inside. Mm. If a bandit are kidnapping, and something is exchanging hand, and they are dropping them back, and then they drop that one, they go for another one. Around deep. Mm. Oh, deep. It is deep to the point that we are like playing with ourselves, or we are not ready to face the truth. Yoruba talk pe eja soju abenko. There is no way you hit the nail on the head, it will not pinch you.
Mm-hmm. It go pinch you now.
It is high time we nail it. We nail it, we conk it, and we feel the pain.
Very true. Now, make we talk about nailing and feeling the pain. Because on top of cocoa of the matter, not to just discuss the problem. The reason why we call them the cocoa, now the most important thing. Now, a solution to this particular problem. Because as they think about parents for different parts of Nigeria, they go look their children every day when they wake up for a weekday, they go school, they look, say, if this pikin go school, and for example, bandits come, carry my pikin, I don't see them for a particular period of time. We don't know whether they're good bandits or bad bandits when they return. Because, for example, like in the case of Leah Sharibu, she never come back. Mm. Some of the Chibok girls, we don't ever see them again. Mm. Some of the Buniyadi boys, rest in peace. Now, these ones, now, the ones where we say they return. Shey parents go fit deal with that particular situation. So we need to find a solution to this particular problem. As somebody when we say, you know how things they go for inside this country, and you get experience. Where you go start from if you want advice, say, look, we find solution to this problem. So that the people go get confidence in government, say, yes, so Government no go allow lawlessness take control. And government no go allow people when we say, no, they do things based on the law to continue to do anyhow.
So first, like you said, it is the cocoa. And when there is cocoa in your swallow, you cannot enjoy that food. Even the cocoa that we drink, the one from our northern brothers, it is not the cocoa that we see in our own swallow. Any swallow that has cocoa is bad.
It will hook you.
Benny, your funeral. This matter has not been, is now starting to hook our neck.
Don't hook us for neck.
To start with, let us ask ourselves. I heard Sheikh saying that the solution is to teach them and to dialogue with them. If the foundation is destroyed, there is nothing anybody can do.
Nothing at all.
I hear from one very learned man somewhere in Europe. He said two things destroy the society. And one society is destroyed, the country is destroyed. He said if there is no education and if there is fear, once those two things are operating, there is no law again.
Serious problem.
These people that you have, I'm not speaking for them. I'm not Sheikh, but I'll tell you, provide good education. Provide an environment whereby people feel like, yes, I am loved. These bandits or banditry or robbery, let's just call it robbery. It's not about, it's robbery. It will cease to exist. What has the government done to provide adequate quality education? A man gave birth to six boys. He could not afford to even send one to school. You can only manage to send one to school. What will become of the remaining five? These people, they just get coerced and taken into any crime that deem fit. And let me tell you, I stand to be corrected. The whole nation is listening. Somebody is behind these people because this huge amount of money cannot just go through one individual.
And even the weapons when they use.
Even if you are buying gun in the black market, it is not for Karimu and Fatai.
Somebody, and then some of them, we even see them, they carry RPG.
And they are not... See, this gun you are talking, it is gun that they use in Civil War. And so how did they enter Nigeria? Who bought it? Who is the middleman that... A lot of things are wrong. So if you are saying the solution is for government to redeem the foundation of this country. Education is essential. Take education out, chaos has broken loose. And what is chaos? Chaos is the high state of unsettlement. Anybody can do anything, and they will get away with it. Is that not what we are seeing? Very from Kankara to Kankara. And only God knows when next it will happen. And we are now advocating that they are good bandits. So are there good thieves and bad thieves? Is a question.
Thief, not thief.
So why are we not saying they are good bandits and they are bad bandits?
Maybe one a victim of circumstance. The other one are the circumstance when do the victim.
Oh, Oronu. And I want to quote our very able information minister. He said there is nothing really bad in Gumi visiting the bandits. He said it is not unusual.
To go visit the bandits.
So, I mean, it is on the TV, it is on social media, on YouTube. Go and search for it. So if it is on, if it is not unusual, where are we going? What are we turning this country to? An average, I was in Kano for almost 3 months. And I see children roaming the streets. I see daddy. So many things are wrong. If we don't address the foundation, there is no solution to this criminal act.
If we don't address the foundation, there is no solution to this criminal act. Now, my Oga, Shembore Oyebanjo, we consider with me for cocoa of the matter. Now, you talk this particular one. Nigeria and our country no go spoil. Make all of us join our hand together to move this our country go the permanent site. If you see bad, call them bad.
Kojuelo.
No way when they go apply makeup for something when we say it don't dey rotting. If he bad, he bad. If he good, he good. Make we ask ourselves, we won't accept bad or we want good. Anybody will accept bad, things go spoil. Society will accept good, now only them feel move forward. Because people when do good go no say then go receive reward. And people when do bad go no say then go receive punishment. Now so what they do every Wednesday from 7 o'clock on top of Wazobia Max TV. Thank you very much.
Based
on social distancing. And when they talk and say coronavirus, they really low. Do very well to protect yourself. Always wear your face mask. Now say my Ubonga visitor to get your own face mask.
It is always around.
Bye-bye. Don't come near me. To enjoy more of this our Ubonga videos when you just watch, Press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.